Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Banished. We're playing the Colonial Charter mod 1.6, the Forge Awakens, and we're in our little starter town of Ramblington. We've built kind of a forest node area here, and thought that we were heading this direction, at least I did, until I realized that the trader can't get to any of these. He is going to be coming down this way. So we changed plans and headed this direction with the center of town. Got two houses built out there and we're waiting on the small market, which I believe they'll be working on next. And just kind of finished up after a little mini-series of exploring all of the buttons. That took a whole lot longer than I thought it would. I thought one episode and I'd be done, and one episode really made it to around here. But I was going through that last episode editing and rendering and realized as I've watched it over again that I never showed this one. This is the small tavern. I talked about it and talked about it and then moved on to the next building. So that was the small tavern compared to the, what we'll say is the regular tavern or inn, and then the big one, the inn and garden. So we'll probably build all three of them at some point in here. So, let's go ahead and turn the game on. We're on speed 5. Very first episode of that little mini-series, I popped into the first tab and started talking about limits. Didn't mean to imply that that's new to Colonial Charter, but rather that as I was about to start talking about Colonial Charter, I realized I haven't looked at limits yet. So, and then I recorded, or did that in that other episode, but didn't save that map. So we're back to the map that was back at episode 2. So let's go ahead and kick our levels up before I forget to do that again. At least to get the logstone and iron up significantly. Fuel we want to control. Food is no reason to ever have limits. Health is normally herbs, but apparently there are multiple items in here now. Oh, here we go. Herbs, healing poultries, healing oils. So this other things. It normally starts at 100. We've already kicked it up to 1,000. So everything else here looks decent enough for a beginning colony, so we'll leave it at that. They're building the small market now, bringing stone over, which we still have plenty of. Good. So what I wanted to start off with was an inventory of our citizens. We've got the parents and then the children, who are now old enough to be, well, parents way beyond old enough to be parents. So we've got a boy and a girl. And so we've got enough to put out at least two more families. So let's do that over here. And let's think about how we want to lay this town out. This is where all of our supplies are going to be available from. Everyone can branch into this like spokes from a wheel. So probably housing around this, though maybe a wood chopper goes in here too, because this will probably pull in logs, and the wood chopper can grab those logs and drop off firewood right here. So wood chopper's going to go in this area somewhere. And I left room to be able to put a nice wide road through town. I think it looks good to have either a road and grass on both sides, or a double road down the center of town, and then the smaller ones branching out, kind of like the main drag and then the pathways. So I want to see if I can make that look happen in this particular playthrough of Banished. So we've got enough supplies to pull off, or do we? No, wait a minute, stone houses require iron, don't they? No, they don't, just stone. Okay, let's start building with stone as well. I like to build with a variety. We'll get just a little of these, a little of this, a little of that, scattered all around our town. So we're coming in at about a tree. So there we go. Just trying to figure out, when I can't see it, where is the red? So the green doesn't count as part of the red of the other building. Okay, so if it's buried in trees, I know that's still even with the other building. One, two. I still leave a couple spaces between. You still have fire issues as well. Let's get an employee over here as well. It just looks good to have a couple of trees and whatnot between the houses. Looks more realistic than cramming everybody into a real tight city. So we are very low on our people, but that's why building more houses is going to help remedy that. So we got that one, and let's pop one more in. Stone house again, but this time, yeah, we got to do some clearing. I don't have to worry too much about the about clearing out all the trees in the area, because these things are growing back hard and fast. But I wanted to get a clearing so I can take a look at this guy and hit the F a couple times, and there we go. What do we want to build here? That's different. Okay, we'll do that. And where are we? Over here. Drop that one in. A couple of spaces. We'll drop that one. Okay. And with that, that's probably a good spot for a road to shoot through. So we'll grab... these will be regular dirt paths. We're in trees right now, but I doubt we're going to be later. One house, two house, space, road. This road goes into... can't really see where that other one hits. Or perhaps it doesn't come down far enough. Oh, we'll let them build that. And let's go ahead and do some logging in this area and kind of give us a view of what we're up against. I want to see the ground a little bit more. We'll do that and see what that does for us. Don't have much in the way of laborers, otherwise I was about to say let's clear out all of the stone and iron in the area, but no point in tying them up quite that bad. Firewood's doing fine, food is doing great. Lumber, all of our supplies are decent enough to keep building for a while. We just don't have any builders. There was the one, let's see, let me think here. Town services, right there. And civic buildings. The town arrival was interesting, except it's a boat. So, but it gives you all of the charting and information you need for the to be able to keep track of what's going on in your town. So I'm thinking let's go ahead and use that one. It's much faster to build than a full town, full-blown town hall. I'm just debating right now, do I want to run a road along the edge here, which makes it difficult to put buildings in? That might be a great place for a trader. I know that'll be a great place for a fishing dock. So where do I run the road? Let's drop the trader in. Let's see here. Think. Storage. Trading. And we could go specific traders, but I like to always put in a real trading post first. So no matter what happens, I can get a random variety of pieces coming in. And I just realized, if I'm going to put fish over here, I want to put that in first. So, food, raw resources, fish. We won't build it right now, but let's get it laid out. So, you can see it's going to need this entire sweep right here. That looks like the most water that I can get attached to it. Okay, so that's going to go there, and that's going to be pinned so that I can see it. Now, let's go back and grab that trader. Storage, trading, and just your general trading post. Don't think that's red. I think that's just the coloring of it. So something along these lines still gives us room here to run a road past it, which is important. So let's go with that. There's our trader. This one, pause. And we're done with that at the moment. We'll just set it there. Wooden bridge, that's over on the other side. We'll let them work on that at their leisure. Did we ever get the houses in? That's not where we are. So we're building this guy and this guy. And they are bringing supplies over there. We're still good on supplies. Problem is, it's just two of them bringing them over. That's why it's taking so long. But soon, there were a few of them that were, 6 and 8 and 9 years old? Remember that right? There's an 8, 4, 9, So a 4 and a 9. That's only 2 that are about to become laborers soon. Of course, we need to put the school in soon, too, so they can become educated laborers, but that then steals 6 more years of nobody coming to help, so it's always a major burden putting that first school in and knowing you're going to have no additional labor for, you know, a little more than half a decade. So this one, I think we're going to put a pause on him, get these houses done. So these are the priorities right now. And even this isn't that much of an issue at the moment. We got plenty of food. So we'll work on these guys. And looks like this is their priority at the moment. So what's taking so long for this one? No, this one. There we are. They were probably building some roads yet. How are we doing over here? Blacksmith has made 18 previous season, is at 20 now, and we're in autumn. Don't have any seeds yet. Just thinking autumn is harvest time, but don't have any way to do that. Clothing, we have 4 leather in stock. We're making hide coats, and we have made 22. We'll be shooting for 22 again this time. Okay. And that is more than enough for what we need. So this one is the smelter. This one is the refinery. Okay, this makes the furnace fuel. I'm trying to think here. What are we making furnace fuel for? The blacksmith uses log and iron. Furnace fuel is to power the smelter, which uses furnace fuel and iron ore. Okay. So, made 42 last time. We've done even better this time. So he's got fuel, iron ore, right there, 137. There's a quick save. So there's still plenty in the economy for him to use. And he is making 90 a year. Interesting that it's the same. I guess that's just random, because we haven't finished this year out. There's 98, okay. Just happened to hit it right at the right moment. Bringing in firewood to make it from. So we don't have any access to anything else yet. So firewood, despite that, is still doing decent. But yeah, I think it's time to go and get that chopper in place over here. Let's see, that is... I could probably fit it right there just fine. Unless we're going to put a road around this. Nope, I don't see any reason to. Let's find the chopper. That is here. That's not there. Alright. Refined resources. Lumber. That's not it either. There it is. Chopper. This does take some getting used to. And no, we don't actually have room for it there. On the corner we do. Not much else we would do on the corner other than a small stockpile. I did put a large one over here. Yeah, let's do that. Drop it right on the corner. Fit that in there and see what they're going to do. Let's go and take a look at the bridge. Now, north is actually this way. I probably should get myself used to viewing it like this instead of the way that it opened up at kind of a diagonal. Let's go with... Because there are times when I need to quickly zip over and I'm realizing I'm going in opposite direction because the world is at a diagonal from where I'm going. Three laborers now. Good. The one's about to become a chopper. So how are we doing here? Small market. Lots of blueberries. Bone meal, firewood. So there is firewood and logs over here. That's what I was hoping. So he pulls in the logs, and the chopper will be able to use it. Notice work back and forth with each other. Lots of venison. No leather at the moment, so the tailor is probably pulling all the leather out of the system. Got rough tools left. Otherwise, iron tools. We've got some over here. Got plenty in the system, so they're being stored elsewhere. Let's see, we did stick storage down here, didn't we? Yeah, small barn. So we got most of our iron tools sitting over here. And we're about to finish a couple of things. Let's go ahead and put another builder up. Get a few of these working simultaneously here. Wooden bridge is done. Alright, so this gets them across into the resources over here, and they're already using it. Oh, we're putting the roads in. Okay. And let's grab a road here. And what is our plan over here? This was going to be another forest node. That's right. That was the plan there, to keep our log industry going strong. So let's... Any reason not just to shoot into the middle here? Let's see if I can get where I can see it. That's interesting. Wherever you stop is where it makes a corner. Okay. Yeah, let's just shoot into the middle. We're definitely going to use it. All kinds of stone over here to pull out. Lots of trees. We're doing, our logging is doing pretty good right now, so it's not something that's got to be done this year. Let's make good use of these builders and laborers and see just what we need to do here. We've taken out a lot of logs in this area. We can see our town a little bit now. Let's go ahead and do a little more of that clear cutting in the area. So we'll pull a chunk out of there. There. We'll be getting down into here with our town. And we're going to be building along the coastline too, so we can afford to pull chunks, tracts of trees out of this area. Alright, that'll give them plenty of logs to work with right now. So these logs will most likely be stored right here. Storage is actually going on full. Ah, I did not anticipate that. If we were to get this going, we could start storing items in here that we could be selling. So let's go ahead and get that going. Yeah, I think so. Get the chopper going next. Got folks moving in. Probably could use another house or two if I go and check on ages of kids. Probably going to see there's at least one more family already ready to go. And of them, we could make one a fisherman, one a chopper, and one a trading post. Let's go ahead and turn these on. Let them build. Actually, turn off the fish. Let's get our bridge going through. So where do we want to bridge this? We could pop one vertical right here, and another one over here. Let's do that. So let's road over to it, like so, and bridge. Let's see, we're about even on stone and wood. Let's go with wood. And we'll come off of here, just like so. Road in between. Then, still don't know where the roads need to be here. Need to figure out, I guess nothing's really going to be built in this area. Let's put a diagonal into here, and then pull from here over. Okay, we'll do that. And then, that gives us right here. Could go up here and leave more of the fishing undisturbed, but I think I'd like to have them crossing sooner. Wonder what they would do. We got two bridges so close, I bet you it wouldn't really matter. Alright, let's go beyond. Let's throw another bridge in. Kind of building some infrastructure for later. There we go. And throw a road from there to there. Okay. So we've got a chopper. Alright. Put a citizen to work over there. Help our firewood. I think we have a set for probably 500. We aren't quite making that limit. So this should be just enough to finish him off. So let's put another house in. What else can we qualify to put in? We need planks here. So we need to get our sawmill up and running soon. Until then, well, we can't do the salt box either. So we have wooden house. We've got log cabins over there. Got a tiny shack over here. No, we'll hold off. Maybe the tiny shack's around the next forest node. So let's go with one more wood house. And put them on this side of that road. And let's go ahead and kick the priority up on this one. Where did he go? There he is. Because got a 12-year-old, and he's about to hit adulthood. We've got one that is adult. We can probably pull off two more houses at this point. So a couple of stone, a wood. Let's put a wood right here. Let's drop this road through though before we forget. So that's going to come through like this and shoot off into there. Then we'll put a couple more, three more houses back to back on these guys. Another road down through here eventually. Same thing over here. So move over a little. Just looking at this space right here. We could fit a tiny shack in it, but it would take the entire space. We'll leave that for some kind of decorations later around the market. So that's something to think about in a game like this. With all those decorations that we saw in this area, you do want to leave space around your town. So it's good that I grabbed the very large map, not just the large map. So we can have our towns be, you know, an entire area here, rather than the small clusters that you're used to seeing in Banished. Then we can put fences and all kinds of different signposts and maybe a stack of logs right here in the corner. We've hit our limit. Ah, that's what we needed. Good. Is there any reason to obey that limit? Well, we are starting to drop in our log quantity, but we're also taking a lot of trees down in here. Let's go ahead and kick our limit up. In fact, let's go for the 1,000 mark on the limit. So 80% full here. There's another quick save. I gotta take that, change the timing on that. I think it's doing it every 5 minutes on me. That's right. When I loaded up the beta version of this game, I basically had to reload the entire game. So all of my original settings are gone. I think I had set it before to autosave every half hour. So one house just went in. Got a nice young couple in there. And that's also going to relieve this, because they're going to now fill up their house with a whole variety of these pieces. So let's grab one more house. We're going to put it... Well, where is our road? Okay, that's what we didn't do. Let's go back and finish this one. And we can't. Why can't we? Well, that was interesting. I'm hitting an obstacle right here. And there. These are trees that need to be chopped down still. Okay. So with that road there, we've got a place for another house right here. And let's go with stone this time. Yep. So stone house right here. And that's a corner. Let's grab the one that's got the corner. Well, we do have that's the wrong corner, though. Okay, so I want the one with a corner porch. That would work well. Wow. Autumn. Everything changed on me. Good. So that'll sit right there. Porch wraps around next to the road. I like that. That one's up here. Working on this. We're not going to work on the fishing dock. And we do have the new bridge. Isn't it right in here? There you are. Let's remember we're doing that. And we do have this one. So let's remember we're doing that. So this goes down. Okay. So priority wise, stone house. Let's make sure. Is that correct? There's a 9-year-old. Yeah, may as well get going. So stone house, food is still doing fine. Priority. That is here. So you guys work on that? Good. Taking lots of trees down. And they're probably dropping it all in here. No, they're not. Chopper is starting to clean out the logs out of there. And they're taking some of the logs directly to the building sites, too. So I think we're going to need some storage over here. Inside of a city, you would probably do more of the magazine for storage. But this doesn't seem appropriate for what we're doing. I'm thinking let's put in the two levels of storage barn, which is a building that'll look more like this one when it's done. So second level of storage barn, let's reverse that so the arrows are heading toward town. And so it won't look like a barn when it's done. And let's road through there. Eventually all the roads in this area are going to be stone roads. Okay, hold on. Remove that. And put it in a space over. Because we're putting double roads in here. So let's make sure we've got... In fact, you know what? Let's put it one space further yet. Just so it matches the same pattern of the row of houses. If you were really laying out a city, where would you place it? So back to storage, barn. Okay, so there, and we'll bring it in a space. There we go. There's our storage barn. That one needs to be done probably right after the stone house. We're not in a panic for animals and seeds yet. Our gatherers are doing fine. Do we have that maxed out? Gatherers 4 of 4. Okay. And we were at 5,000, now we're at 4. So it's very possible that we have hit our peak and we're starting to decline because we are adding citizens. So we could try to get some seeds and get some farms going. We could simply stick in another gatherer out here. If you think of it, this will probably be city when it's done, but it could be a gatherer at this point. It's a natural forest sitting right here. So let's go ahead and do that. Even if it's not a permanent building, it will do the job for a couple of decades game time before we expand this direction, because I have a feeling we're going up and over at first. Here's that quick save again. So, what was I saying? Gatherer. That is right here. So let's gather from this area. Right there. And how do we want to road into this? Probably up like this. So let's road a mossy path from here to here. And then here, diagonal into... Yeah, something like that. Okay. And 4,900. Yeah, we'll make the barn the next priority. So this one's done. And barn is the next priority. And then let's get this guy in the roster, and he will be maybe the next one. We'll see. They haven't started bringing the materials to these projects yet. They are building the trading post. Materials are all there. May as well let them get that finished and see what comes our way. Firewood's in the 700s, so we will actually have something to trade. Good. Logs are doing fine, because we have plenty of room to clear cut right now. You know what I don't know? These appear under trees. When the trees leave, do these eventually despawn if you don't collect them? Or will they stay there for decades until something gets built over them? I don't know that I've really paid attention enough to watch what happens year after year when they're no longer under trees. Stone is low, so let's do two things. Grab stone from... may as well grab it from right in this area. Cube a bunch, and let's grab food right there from the areas that we have stripped out. Nope, didn't need to do that. The gatherer will do this, but that'd be fine. We've got 6 laborers at the moment. Oh, good. So rather than immediately assign them to new jobs, let's just let them continue. 2 builders. Trader, where are you? takes 4, but they are prioritized on the storage barn. And it takes 4. Alright, we'll go ahead and kick that up. Otherwise, we'll let the laborers just labor away for a while. We're in no rush. This is a huge map, and I could see doing this game for the next several months. We'll see. We'll see what happens. We'll see if I have myself a... Okay, I'm going to pause the game right here before we start filling up. See if we have ourselves enough disasters to change my plans completely. So here's the storage warehouse. And for those of you who've never done any upgrading in Banished or never seen it before, it'll tell you what... Oh, there's something I didn't anticipate. Tell you what you need to build the new one, for starters. 24 planks, 6... Well, it's either stone or iron. I think it's stone. And 1... is that building materials? This guy, building supplies. Then you have homewares and fancy homewares. Those are the 3 crates that show up in building material lists like that. So just a generic box of building supplies that are needed to do a higher level construction than just your typical farm barn. So that's kind of what this represents. And we don't have the home building supplier yet, so we're not going to be upgrading this guy. So, that is out. I was going to pause this before they started filling it, because in order to upgrade it, you've got to tear it back down again, then recycle some of those building supplies and rebuild it as this one. It's kind of frustrating you can't go straight to this level, but that's the way it's done. So, in that case, we're going to go ahead and let them use that storage. So, storage is taken care of. Housing... How are we doing now? We have a 25-year-old needs a wife. We have a 13-year-old that needs a wife. We have an 11-year-old who's at the mercy of one of those two to become their wife. Who's out here? One. We have a 12-year-old needs a wife. A lot of guys. A lot of guys. So we have at least one family yet in the works. Food is starting to drop a little. Trading post is in. Okay. So tell you what, with that, let's go ahead and call this one an episode. And next time we'll figure out the trading post, what we want to stock that with, get the gatherer. Looks like it's already, well, it's supplied, it's not building. So where are the builders right now? They're stationed at the 2 bridges. All right. So let them build the bridges. I see they're assigned to the bridges, but the materials aren't there, so they still got to bring all the materials over. But wood is, or food has dropped to 4,000, so tell you what, so that we don't forget, let's remind ourselves for next time that that is the priority. Get that stock with some of these extra laborers and get this food back on the uphill so we can keep adding houses. So we need to add a house, we need to figure out the trading, and go from there. So, I thank you folks for watching. Please hit the like and subscribe down below so we can add more folks to the channel. And see you next time, folks. Bye-bye.